the most popular person, the biggest star, pop culture star in Myanmar, and Alexandre Machado of Brazil. Can he possibly tap out Aung La N Sang? A chance go up for Aung La early.
We're seeing that size discrepancy you were talking about, Michael. Look how big Machado is. Aung La's pressing forward.
Look out for the right hand, the big tub thumper on Aung La N Sang. Roundhouse kick from Aung La. Machado's got to get this contest to the ground. Even he knows it. He said to us yesterday, I can't match Aung La standing. I need to get it down. But once I'm down, that's my world.
But the Burmese Python has got such slick submission skills, and he's also got really good wrestling. He's got good takedown defense, and he can push opponents. He's got huge...
Oh, the big kibosh! Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you, set for five rounds. Outside leg early from Aung La N Sang, right hand down the corridor from Karaki. Roving with the lead hand, outside leg kick from Aung La N Sang. Karaki goes for a jab right combination. Overhand right there from Aung La. Going for the headache maker early. And Karaki wants to take him down. Locks up to a single leg here.
Good defense here for Aung La. Now he's trying to swim underneath. He's got to be careful of that head. The battle is going to be won or lost on that head, but he does a good job of pulling up that wizard and keeping that head off of his center line. See how Karaki's driving his head into Aung La? This is very important. You can see that Aung La is trying to control that wizard, and he does a great job of defending right there.
Last time out against Ken Hasegawa, Aung La N Sang produced the greatest match of all time with a fifth round knockout you've never seen before. It was amazing. Will he be forced to dig deep into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude again here tonight? He predicted he would finish Karaki inside of three. There's an uppercut. He's leveled Karaki.
Try and put Ngalani on his back and grind it. Big arm, right through Aung La! Look at the monstrous Ngalani too.
He's got to relax right now. He's got to control the position, not use too much strength. Nice guard recovery by Aung La.
Aung La working off his back. Double butterfly hooks here. Now a single butterfly.
Continues to be deafening around us. The excitement at fever pitch, these two big men in the center of the cage. And it's Big Dash, who won't give any ground going backwards just yet. And then as I speak, he just drifts off to take a moment. Sends out that left jab. Aung La looks strong, he looks broad across the shoulder.
Aung La's got to get moving. He cannot stand in the middle of the cage in one spot and allow Vitaly Big Dash to set up some of those big strikes.
Just as you started saying that, Mitch, Big Dash landed a little short right hand to the temple just to show us all what he can do. If you don't use your judgment, your sense of distance correctly, and he comes round with a flashy spinning back kick that Aung La just stepped out of range for. A left hand from Aung La N Sang.
Both traded hooks there on that exchange. Vitaly Big Dash loves to showcase those kicks coming from a karate background.
And you can see that the size of these men means that when they land big. There's no flicking punches here. These are heavy punches that are being buried into the target. And that punch greeted with rapturous reception by the fans here.
That's what Aung La has to do. He has to increase the volume of these punches. Do not let Big Dash get comfortable and start unloading on him.
Right hand from Aung La N Sang. And listen to the fans. Five-minute rounds, so potentially here, 25 minutes. They've done that distance once. Big Dash, the winner by decision. But in that fight, Aung La N Sang didn't have a proper training camp, and he's showing now that he did have a good camp, and he's caught Big Dash with the left hand. Yuji Shimada's poised. Big Dash is very durable, but Aung La N Sang continues to rain down the punches. Big Dash looks composed. His body is being contorted in all kinds of shapes as this crowd goes absolutely mad around this arena. Big Dash tries to pull him in, but more heavy blows from the Burmese fighter, lefts and rights. Big Dash covers up, throwing nothing back. Yuji Shimada continues to look very closely indeed. Big Dash pulls him in by the neck, trying to cut that distance down, but the big punches continue to come in. The crowd absolutely baying for this fight to finish. Landed flush on the jaw of Vitali Big Dash, but you're absolutely right, Mitch. He is so durable, the Russian, in this situation. We've seen it before.
He has to be very careful. Aung La has to brace himself and realize he can't finish. He's got to slow back down. Big Dash is going for the attacks, but I think Big Dash is still hurt.
He doesn't show any sign of wanting to get up just now. Come on back down, he says, beckoning him in with his hands.
How composed Big Dash looks.
And Yuji Shimada, the only man in that cage who can bring Big Dash to his feet, but he doesn't look too keen to stand up, does he? And you might be right, Mitch. He may be carrying some kind of an injury.
I think he's still hurt. Those were some big shots landed by the Burmese Python.
Big right hand again. And one from Big Dash as well.
Oh! Dangerous, but right, these shots are connecting.
These fans going crazy as we enter the final 50 seconds. Aung La N Sang lands a couple of decent uppercuts inside, but Big Dash is so durable. Comes back with punches of his own. Aung La N Sang with an elbow downwards in its motion onto the head of Big Dash. And it's the Russian going backwards, and you don't see that too often. What a thrilling 5 minutes. I'm sad to tell you that there's only 25 seconds left of this opening round.
Don't worry, Steve. We still got 20 minutes left of this world title fight.
This crowd making more noise than I've ever heard at a mixed martial arts event anywhere in the world.
I thought the roof was about to pop off this place.
Right, left, right from Aung La N Sang. He even has time to adjust his hair. And that is the end of an absolutely thrilling action-packed round. And look how much these fans appreciate that.
What a round, Steve. Big Dash got dropped. Aung La jumped all over him. But look at him, he looks composed. He looks okay. Let's take a look. Look at that overhand right. Slips through the guard of Big Dash and lands a nice four-punch combination. I like the hammer fist there at the end. But the composure of the champion, able to relax himself, realize, and we've seen this before. We've seen Big Dash get dropped on multiple occasions, but still keep himself together, come back and win. Don't count the champion out, but take a look at the challenger, Steve.
When Vitali Big Dash made his walk to the cage, we wondered, didn't we, aloud, whether we were going to see another Big Dash spirit fight. Well, that first round is showing us every piece of evidence that we're about to. Big Dash opens his arms out and encourages the crowd to get even louder, if that is at all possible. He's enjoying the atmosphere just as much as everybody else is, by the look of things. Second round.
Aung La's confidence has got to be just as high as the energy inside this stadium.
flicks his arms out just to get a bit loose and then looks for a big right hand, but Big Dash quick, nimble, round the back. Now what
nice
can he do here, Mitch?
Rip! Those are beautiful takedown. He's kind of got on the side. Aung La's going to turn into that.
Oh, strong man, turn around. The noise absolutely deafening around and above us. Elbows from Aung La N Sang, but Big Dash is strong, and he gets up once more.
He just stands up, pure strength to get back to his feet from the champion.
Aung La N Sang is cut around the mouth, nothing too serious, I would think. Something that maybe might affect him as the fight goes on.
Big Dash pressing the challenger up against the cage. Has one underhook there on the left side. Aung La's posturing the head out, framing off, and his short elbows are landing on Big Dash.
Doesn't the Burmese fighter look composed, though? Not unsettled at all, not rattled whatsoever, as this crowd make more noise than we can really tolerate here at cage side.
Immediately, the People's Champion gets right to the center of the cage, starts to measure out those strikes.
Big Dash shaken slightly there, not in any hurry to get back and engage again.
Big Dash does not look fully recovered. He seems a little bit off, just slightly askew, but that could be his that could be part of the play. That could be part of his tactic to lure Aung La into a false sense of security.
Superb left hand from Aung La N Sang. He's picking off Big Dash almost at will at times. But this man has superhuman abilities.
Again, look at that. Shoots in, takes the back of Aung La. But Aung La is a wizard in the grappling exchanges. He's possibly threatening out the Kimura there. Nice takedown from the champion to get the back of the challenger. Got both hooks in. The choke looks like it's in. He's flattening him out, Steve.
He's giving it up. In come the punches instead.
Those big shots. Hurts. You can hear the thud.
The left arm looking to go around that throat once more, but again, Aung La N Sang has his arms in the way.
Aung La, he's got to posture now. He's got to try to work back up, but that's so difficult when you have a man the size of Big Dash on top of you.
Can't use the cage to lever himself up, remember. He can't grasp the cage with his hands. Has to use leg strength, but as you say, Big Dash is just sitting on him.
You can see him start to shrug those shoulders up and slowly start to move. Big Dash is going to want to pull his back away from the cage and stay in this top position.
Aung La N Sang just looks aside to his corner men, looks at the crowd as if he had time to do such a thing, but he looks remarkably composed. All the while taking punches to the left side of his body, and they'll be hurting. Vitaly Big Dash is a big man, and Yuji Shimada wants to see action in the center of the cage. Entertaining, but is that the right call, Mitch?
I don't know. Yuji's not giving these guys much chance to work. Big Dash was landing the punches, but it wasn't enough for Yuji Shimada. He wanted these guys on their feet.
Aung La N Sang, center cage. Vitaly Big Dash roaming around the periphery. Big right hand from Aung La N Sang, and he backs off after having sent it in. And a huge right hand from Vitaly Big Dash, exchanging single blows. Final minute of the second round now.
Good head movement by the challenger, and there is that left high kick.
And listen to this crowd. Uppercut inside from Aung La N Sang as Big Dash pushes him up against the cage wall.
Let's see what Big Dash can do. He's got him pressed up against the cage. He's got about 30 seconds to work. This is a bit closer than the first round. We've seen a lot more control from the top position from Big Dash. Again, we're not judging these fights round by round. This fight is judged on a whole, and we still got three rounds to go.
If it goes that far, big, big elbow and forearm from Big Dash, connecting with Aung La N Sang, just above his right eye. No sign of any cut there, though, just yet. Despite the punishment being taken, the second round is over. 10 down. 15 to go. I know it's difficult to judge while you're commentating, Mitch. But has Aung La slightly got the edge after 10 minutes?
Oh, look at that beautiful inside trip there to have Big Dash get on top, get the back, Aung La does the right thing, goes belly to belly there, and then controlling a lot of the positions because of the damage and the significant strikes landed in the first round. We gotta give a slight edge to Aung La, but Big Dash is starting to regain the composure. And what's the word we used? Durability, Steve.
That's what Vitaly Big Dash is all about. Those submission attempts would certainly have brought him back into the contest, but perhaps, dare we speculate, perhaps the Burmese Python with the edge. 15 minutes still to go. And it was in the third round, you might recall, of their first contest that Vitaly Big Dash connected with a stupendous kick to the head, which changed the course of that fight.
Round three, fight!
Deja vu all over again, as Yogi Berra once said.
Unlock pushes forward. You can hear the crowd getting behind their man as we're getting started in the third round.
Knee to the head from Vitaly Big Dash, and Aung La N Sang does not want to be caught by one of those. But look how composed he is. He's never very light on his feet, but planting those feet as he does gives him that extra power when he lands. He just does not look hurried, does he, Aung La N Sang? He'll do this at his own pace, despite the fact that the crowd are encouraging him to step up the effort.
That's what Aung La has to do. He has to start pushing, putting these combinations together. Big Dash doesn't want no more of it. Stand up with Aung La, immediately get this fight to the ground, and that's where he's having the most success. You would think that the striking specialist would want to keep it striking, but he's choosing to take this fight to the ground while the submission guy is having the most success on his feet.
Well, we recall how much he was stung in those first 5 minutes from the power of Aung La N Sang. No wonder then that he chose to take that driving takedown just 20 seconds ago and put the fight on the mat.
Aung La has the overhook there, and that's preventing Big Dash from kind of posturing away, but a nice pull away from the cage to swivel Aung La's hips back down onto the mat. So Aung La's not able to use the cage to walk back up.
From sitting up to lying down, that's the position that Aung La N Sang finds himself in now. And he becomes increasingly exposed to those forearms on the face. We know he's got strength, and he puts himself back into, or tries to get back into that sitting position up against the cage wall. But Big Dash is strong.
Look at what he's doing to the wrist, Steve. He immediately takes that wrist away.
Almost
with the sweep.
Back and forth.
But this is what happened last time, Steve. In the third, fourth, and fifth round, it was Big Dash all over Aung La.
He's tremendously well-conditioned, the Russian.
He physically towers over his opponents, utilizing that strength and conditioning to really start to gain the edge in a lot of these later rounds.
As you can see from Big Dash's back, Aung La N Sang's forearms and the canvas, how much perspiration is now playing a part. Difficult to get a purchase on those bodies as you try and manipulate them into a position where you might try to take advantage. Slippery little suckers, these two now.
Immediate again. Yuji Shimada gets these guys back up. He's got to give these guys time to play on the
left
ground.
Hand from Aung La N Sang. It was a straight left, and it sent perspiration flying from the head of Big Dash, who goes for the double leg and succeeds.
Nice double leg takedown. And that's where the champion's having a lot of success. He's got to be careful of that butterfly sweep coming from the challenger. But those hips are just so heavy. He's got so much pressure from the top position. Immediately he goes after the wrist, but Aung La is able to work his way back up to his feet.
And listen to what the crowd think of that tremendous leg strength. But will he get taken down again? He does, and these are point-scoring moves if he can work from position.
The champion again with the big takedown. He's got to get active, though. Otherwise, Yuji's going to pop these guys back up to their feet again. And I think that's what Aung La wants.
70 seconds left in round three. We are past the halfway mark of this contest.
You can see the challenger, Aung La, grabbing the head, keeping Big Dash close to him. And Yuji might stand these guys up again real soon. Big Dash has to be more active with
and there's a lot of blood, Mitch, on Aung La N Sang's forehead. It looks to be either up in the hairline or to the left of his left eyebrow.
The hips are just floating around as Aung La is trying to leverage those hips up and possibly sweep or create a scramble. But look, Aung La is doing the right thing.
And the crowd get into it again.
30 seconds left.
Final half minute of this third round.
Big Dash has got to be active. Fuji's going to stand these guys up with about 20 seconds left to go in the third, and we're almost in the championship rounds.
I'm sure Big Dash has seen that cut, and I'm sure he'll be looking to use his forearm as he has done so effectively in the past and indeed earlier on in this contest. Aung La N Sang draws him in close to remove that leverage, take away the advantage. Well, the third round was a turning point in their first fight. Have we seen a similar turning point just now?
Look here, that's the story of this round, was that top pressure from the champion. A near sweep by Aung La, but Big Dash was able to stay on top. He needs to be a little bit more active when he does get on top. There's a brute strength takedown by the champion to end up on top. Now, who is gonna dig deep? Who wants it more? Will this crowd come into play and rise up and give Aung La the burst he needs? Can't wait to find out.
There's no question there are three parties involved in this fight. The two men in the cage and 12,000 or so outside of it, making so much noise.
Seconds out, please.
These are the championship rounds, the rounds that separate men from boys. These two have done it all before. Effectively, this now for these two is round nine. But we're not concerned with the first fight anymore. They start from scratch. Who's got the edge now? It was a good third round for Vitali Big Dash. And Aung La N Sang may need to step up the pace. Easier said than done as the fatigue starts to set in. Big overhand right, heavy, heavy blow.
Aung La cannot allow Big Dash to pressure him up against the cage and get that takedown, because he's gonna wanna get this fight back to the ground, dominate the top position. Aung La's gotta strike and move. Get on his bicycle, keep movement around and not circle to that strength side of Big Dash. Nice head kick there.
118 countries around the world tuning into this one. And if you're not familiar with our rule set, let me just let you know that the judges will score this fight in its entirety. So we're not going round by round. These fighters will be very aware, therefore, of how close this one is.
This is where Aung La's having the most success. He's utilizing that improved boxing. Now he's got the cardio to push this fight and the volume of his strikes up.
3 minutes 30 left in the fourth round. And we've been on our feet for the first 90 seconds of this one. And that, you imagine, is where Aung La N Sang wants it to be.
This is definitely where he's been able to have the most success in this fight, is in the stand-up.
Nice high guard from the Burmese Python. Just cutting off those straight punches as Big Dash throws them in.
That left high kick comes out so fast. There's no setup at all. He just whips that leg up.
Oh, superb right uppercut from Aung La N Sang, and it caught Big Dash flush, and I think Big Dash for a moment wondered if maybe there was an eye poke. He's looking at the referee, not happy about something, but he's able and willing to fight on, though. He gave a nod to Aung La N Sang, saying, yep, let's carry on. Certainly it was a heavy blow that shook Big Dash's head backwards, and again the perspiration went flying off, a left hand to the head, as the Burmese Python goes head hunting, and successfully so in the last 30 seconds.
I'd like to see him follow up, because as he's throwing these strikes and these combinations, Big Dash is kind of covering up. If he would punctuate it with a leg kick or a body shot, he may be able to find a weakness in the armor of Big Dash.
did in the first round when he put together multiple strikes in that four-punch combination and sent him to the canvas.
2 minutes left in the fourth, Mitch. And Aung La N Sang. Yuki Shimada warning Vitaly Big Dash. I'm not quite clear what that was about.
Action.
Oh, okay.
Yuji Shimada wants just that.
Okay.
He wants these guys to put on the fight that we saw in the first.
And he replies with a nice crisp little right hand to Aung La N Sang's jaw. And they clash heads as they come together. No damage though. 1.5 minutes left of this fourth round. Aung La N Sang still able to bounce on his feet every now and then, showing that he's benefited from a full camp this time, unlike in their first fight when he took the fight at only 10 days' notice. Vitaly Big Dash again communicating only with Aung La N Sang, says, watch those fingers, you're coming very close to my eyes, if not going in them. No timeout injury,
though. 1 minute left in round number 4.
You can see Aung La try to frame off, create a little bit of space, and he did open up his hands. He might have brushed slightly, but I don't think there was any malicious intent on his part. But Yuji again consistently pushes forward. No takedown attempts from the champion this round.
Mitch, a little over 5 minutes left of this contest. What does Aung La N Sang need to do to capture the judge's eye?
He's got to put these punches together in bunches, multiple hit combinations. Now he's only throwing 1 and 2 punch combos. If he puts them together, Big Dash covers up and it creates a lot of openings for him.
You can see nice. Fatigue is starting to set in.
I think it's been there for a while, but these fighters are reaching down deep and displaying the heart of a warrior.
The hearts of a champion and a two-time now challenger. Who will come away with the belt around their waist? 5 minutes left to go. Another round of heavy blows. This time, most of it, if not all of it, Mitch, on the feet. And that's where Aung La N Sang wanted it to be, but as you said, did he throw enough in terms of combinations?
That round was almost dead even, very close. You've got the damage sustained by Big Dash in the first round. You've got the dominant top control in the second and third round from the champion. That fourth round could have been a wash, could have been even both ways. I think it comes down to the fifth and final round because I still believe this is anybody's fight.
And isn't that just the way we wanted it to be? After 20 minutes, everything to fight for in the final five.
I don't think anybody in this stadium would have it any other way.
Well, there may be a few thousand people behind you who would have preferred that it was over perhaps a bit quicker in that man's favor, but I'm sure they're enjoying the thrill, the excitement, the competitiveness. Fifth and final round. Vitaly Big Dash, the champion, to the left and now rear, right of your screen. In the foreground, Aung La N Sang.
See, it's that combination. It's those multiple strikes where Aung La's having the most success. It could be enough to take this fifth round if he continues to do it. Because he's landing a lot of these strikes. They're slipping right past Big Dash's guard.
The crowd getting involved again. There can't be much in this fight. Surely the outcome will be determined in the next 4 minutes and 18 seconds.
We're past 45 minutes that these guys have been doing battle. The amount that you learn about your opponent in 45 minutes is a tremendous amount of time. Who has got the strategy of their opponent figured out enough to capture this prestigious middleweight world title?
Has the groundwork of Vitaly Big Dash made a difference? Has the fact that he's thrown punches in bunches made a difference? Has the strong, damaging single punches of Aung La N Sang, particularly in those first 10 minutes, made a difference? All will be told there. A superb example of the power that the Burmese Python can unleash on the champion.
Nice takedown defense from the challenger. Reaching down deep. That's what he needs to do. Multiple strike combinations. He's putting those punches together. Stop the takedown. Keep this on the feet. Unload those combos.
And that injury on the left side of Aung La N Sang's face continues to show visible signs of trouble. Brings up that left leg to the side of Big Dash's face.
Aung La taking a page from the champion's book by throwing that no-show leg kick, left high kick.
Big opportunity here, Mitch, as you watch it, for somebody just to be a little bit busier and show the judges that they are the ones who deserve the win.
See, Aung La is getting success when he throws multiple strikes. The third strike is landing. Big takedown attempt from the champion.
Will that make the difference? They know that something small will decide the margin.
Aung La's got to get back up to his feet.
Keep going.
This could be it for the challenger unless he can work his way back up. Did he do enough in the early rounds?
I think the crowd are baying for Yuji Shimada to ask him to get back onto their feet.
Nice scramble to use the cage to get back up to his feet from Aung La.
Yuji separates them, and he will indeed take them to the center of the cage. The crowd love it. Mitch, there's 2 minutes left. Everything to fight for.
What does Big Lash have? What does Big Dash have left in the tank? What can Aung La draw from this crowd to possibly see a title shift? Oh, big takedown from Big Dash again with a very awkward double leg takedown. But again, because of these unique variations of these takedowns that are coming from the champion, he's able to get this fight back down to the ground, and he's nowhere near the cage. So Aung La is gonna have to create a scramble, have to create some movement, or tie up Big Dash like he's doing and hope Yuji pops him back up.
80 seconds left. It's gonna be difficult without Yuji's help for Aung La N Sang to get back on his feet and show us what he can do.
Dash is staying active enough. That body head.
And final round.
We got 1 minute to go in the world championship tilt.
Keep going.
Vitaly Big Dash, unbeaten at 9-0. This is his second defense of the world title he won in a thrilling contest against Igor Swirid. Here in a contest just as thrilling. And with the added noise of the fans here, that are right behind the challenger, but has he done enough in the final 30 seconds of this contest with his back to the canvas?
See, Aung La's active from the back. He's trying to move, he's trying to create space, but the champion has given him no room to breathe. Consistently, body head combinations, staying active enough so that Yuji is forced to let him stay in the position.
Final seconds of this contest, and this one will go to the judges.
And you, world middleweight world champion, the Burmese Python, and Sang.
Well, as that judge's decision was announced, Vitaly Big Dash had his hand in the air, expecting to get the decision, but it was not so. Those tremendously hard punches from Aung La N Sang were enough to persuade the judges, and let me emphasize, unanimously so, that he is the new one championship middleweight title holder as the confetti falls from the ceiling.
Asagawa, Michael Ciavello, Mitch Chosunriki. Main event from Yangon, Myanmar. It's one championship. Aung La N Sang, tremendous power in his roundhouse kicks, in his punches. So too, the thickly built Ken Hasegawa.
Aung La N Sang looks very intense, while Hasegawa looks very relaxed.
A new training camp for Aung La N Sang in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
That right hand of Aung La snuck right through the guard.
Right roundhouse kick from Aung La N Sang. Hasegawa, the deep megaton, open weight champion, comes here very well credentialed. Bouncing left hand there from Ken Hasegawa. Omar showing patience, edges forward as the champion. Probing with the jab out of southpaw stance, Ken Hasegawa. Jab to the cross there from Hasegawa, just falls short for the Japanese martial artist. Outside leg kick misses the target from Aung La N Sang. Second one connects for Aung La.
Hasegawa's starting to find a home for that left hand. He's trying to gauge the distance as he's cutting through the guard of Aung La. Right there, just landed again.
The left cross, the power cross of the southpaw from Japan. Body shot off the lead hand from Aung La. Aung La, two-punch combination, grazing with the left. Goes to southpaw stance, Aung La.
Aung La's landed a few times, though, but Hasegawa's wearing it well.
Jab there from Aung La N Sang, switches back to orthodox stance now. There's the champion. Hasegawa threads the high left roundhouse kick.
Nice little combination from Hasegawa, left hand, left kick.
They're going to change levels perhaps, mix it up a little here. Again, Hasegawa almost circles into that right roundhouse kick. The roundhouse kick that knocked out Machado. Fake there from Aung La. Thought about throwing the right hand down the tube. Resets from center cage. Left cross falls short for Hasegawa. An intriguing half a round down so far. Roundhouse kick to the upper left ribs there from Aung La.
These guys are very similar. Like they have very almost duplicate styles, like they're going against a mirror. They've got the same jab straight combination, same big roundhouse kick coming off the rear leg.
Every time Aung La lands, this crowd goes crazy. A sellout again inside the mighty Toronto Indoor Stadium. High right roundhouse kick there for Aung La. Two-punch combination, Hasegawa had some fire on the lead hand. Both men showing tremendous respect for the capabilities of one another. They give instruction coming from the corners. Now gets out of the way of the two-punch combo. Hasegawa resets. The southpaw from Japan. Oh, the right hand! Smack bang! Smack bang! First real power salvo from Aung La N Sang. And Hasegawa rallies back. Aung La applying the pressure, coming forward. Hasegawa locking eyes with the champion. Step through knee, and Hasegawa backs him off with the right hand. Both men showing some terrific boxing so far here, Mitch.
These are big middleweights, putting a lot of power behind these heavy hands.
Hasegawa, a game opponent with 25 seconds on the clock.
Hasegawa competing against one of the best middleweights in the world, the best middleweight in the world, but he's also got these 10,000 Myanmar fans against him as well.
And we are told that one in every three of this country of 55 million is watching live, watching their hero, Aung La N Sang, defend the middleweight world title.
Take a look at some of Aung La's shots here. Look at that, he caught a kick. Caught a right hand on the chin, and then he got hit with a kick. That was the best combination of Ken Hasegawa, but Aung La comes right back with a nice overhand right of his own. Back and forth action, very close first round. Some wise words coming off of Henry Hooft, the head coach for Aung La N Sang, as he takes
tells me he wants to make sure that he covers up a little bit better, make sure he keeps his hands nice and tight.
Round two.
Second round set for five. We're seeing a fantastic toe-to-toe matchup so far. Roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Aung La. Thumping right hand down the center corridor from the champion. Hasegawa backs him off with the lead hand. Power in both hands of the southpaw.
Hasegawa's starting to march forward. Trying to put punches together in bunches.
Aung La's got to keep that left hand up because the right lead of Hasegawa is finding the mark.
That's what Henry Hove told him. He said he wants to keep his hands nice and close to his chin. A little bit of a slip there from Aung La.
A very humid atmosphere inside Tawana Indoor Stadium. Aung La N Sang looks to get on the inside. Hasegawa almost walked into that rising knee.
Hasegawa's starting to push forward a bit more on his boxing. Cutting a little bit of angles. This is typically what we see from Aung La. Aung La likes to pivot out to the right and left very well.
A hook to a left cross there.
Look at the welt starting to develop on Hasegawa's left rear.
It is purple and deep red from the roundhouse kicks off the back leg of Aung La N Sang. Hasegawa fights. Aung La fires out a front kick. Those booming chants go up again for Aung La N Sang. He drops one down to the belly button. Hasegawa threads the left cross nicely. He's got a bit of pepper behind it. Aung La looks to close the gap. Stumbles backwards, clips him with a short right hook.
Looks like that caught him off balance, though, as Aung La stumbles backwards, and a nice left or right hand from Hasegawa.
Hasegawa again, a popping jab, takes another rib kick. Hasegawa's got some fire in his hands. Aung La taking his time, not overextending himself, not rushing. A cerebral performance from the champion. Jab cross combo there from the challenger. The cross lands again, but he didn't have the torque. He didn't turn into it. Toe to toe. Hasegawa comes forward, straight line punches. A high right roundhouse kick from Aung La. Hasegawa backs him off with another cross. Aung La takes two solid blows to the jaw. Got to keep the hands up, the champion. This is a good boxing spell here, Mitch, from the challenger.
And Hasegawa's really putting his punches together nicely. He's finding a home, he's finding that range with his jab, and his counter strike is looking clean. Very good round so far for Hasegawa.
Hasegawa.
Burmese Python has a really good guillotine, so Hasegawa's got to be careful, make sure he keeps his head high on that entry.
Edges forward again, does the check. Aung La N Sang, second round set for five for the world middleweight title clash. Little dipping body shot at the right hand there from Aung La. Flips him with a left hook. Body shot from Aung La. Throws out the front kick. What a battle we are seeing for the world title. Aung La, right hand lead. Hasegawa threads a right hand of his own, that being the lead hand of the southpaw.
In those close distance exchanges, that's Hasegawa's best time. He's starting to catch Aung La when Aung La's lightning's up.
Hasegawa cuts on the side of the right eye.
Ooh, nice hook, straight combo.
Hasegawa jab two, follows through with another right hand. Oh, the right of his own, and Hasegawa every moment of this world title match. Fantastic back and forth action. Both men landing heavy shoulders. The handiwork of Hasegawa in the second round. But there's a good look at the cut in a very dangerous spot.
Round and three. Champion
as he defends the crown. Third round of five.
Little mouse under the eye of the champion. Little cut under the eye of the challenger. Third round, here we go.
And sweat flies up the brow of both as they both land punches. There's it. Flipping overhand, left out of southpaw starts from Aung La. Hasegawa backs him off with the left hand. A beautiful left hook there from Hasegawa. A double jab from the Japanese challenger.
That reverberated all throughout the stadium.
Hasegawa back to left once more. Now it's on the top. Oh, the uppercut! The uppercut! Puts the champ through the top of the head.
I think that kick rocked Hasegawa. Aung La is feeling it.
Here it comes, Aung La! And Hasegawa backs him against the fence. A high knee from Aung La N Sang. This is going to to pass to go to side control.
Oh, Hasegawa is able to get past the guard of the Burmese Python. This is where Hasegawa excels. He is so strong in this position. Look for him to drop elbows and try to crucifix.
Aung La N Sang back to his feet, drills a body shot. This crowd is crazy. Uppercut from Aung La. Hasegawa tags him. Looks for the uppercut again. A downward elbow. A crossing elbow. Hasegawa does a quick count of his teeth. Aung La goes for the body. Trying to soften up the midsection. Hasegawa breathing heavy. There's a huge mouse swelling up the right eye of Aung La N Sang. Uppercut from the champion.
The challenger's mouth is wide open, but he's still coming forward. Aung La wisely starts to go to the body.
This is like something out of a Hollywood movie. Back and forth, a slugfest. Oh, a solid left cross there from Hasegawa. Aung La throws a roundhouse kick. The champ comes forward again. A bolo punch from the champion. A body rip to the liver. Hasegawa to the head. Turn and turn once more. This is guts and intestinal fortitude personified. Both men letting it all hang out. They're pulling out all the stops.
Both guys have bit down on their mouthpiece and are just throwing hands.
This is what they came to see. This is pure theater. A right hand lands from Aung La N Sang. A wild looping left. He's in southpaw stance for Chan. Hasegawa backs him off. Hasegawa's hands around his waist. This is epic. This is awesome.
The left eye of Aung La is starting to swell shut. Hasegawa is marching forward, landing shots.
What a show! It's pure box office! A spinning backfist attempt from Hasegawa. Here comes Aung La N Sang! He tags him with the right hand again! What more have they got left in the tank? These two incredible martial artists! So again, they're giving it their all. This is one for the ages. Aung La goes to the body.
Michael, and this is the third round. 40 seconds left as Aung La marches forward with a big stiff right jab.
Both of Aung La's eyes are swollen now. Still the champ comes forward, goes to the sternum, backs up the challenger. What about a clinch and knee? 20 seconds remain in the third round as Hasegawa lands across to the jaw. Jab from the challenger, jab two. This has been amazing. The atmosphere, the battle, the moment.
I like how Aung La is starting to go to the body. He's mixing it up. Hasegawa is just headhunting. Aung La is attacking the body just as much as he's attacking the head. Take a look at some of this action. There was a big exchange, but then the counter off the right hands, but then Aung La landed a sneaky uppercut with his right. Constant action from these two as they go toe to toe, back and forth, just landing big punches. Now, Michael, this is unseen territory.
Fourth round, the penultimate round. They call these the championship round. It is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar, and it is a blockbuster. The cage door closes. Aung La's stolen shot. And Hasegawa, as Mitch said, has to dig deep, has to go to a place inside of himself that he's never been to before. This is when it becomes more than physical. And Hasegawa shoots in, almost stops the takedown.
And now he's trying to transition to the back. Hasegawa caught him, the mouth guard goes out.
Knees to the ribs. That'll make it even harder. Hasegawa wobbling around the cage. How much more does the challenger have left? It has been an absolute beauty, a rip snorter. Aung La with the right hand, the body shots. Hasegawa tags him with the left cross. Hasegawa again. Both these men, more punch than a high school prom. There's a right hand from Aung La. There's a stiff uppercut. It's all boxing now. They're fighting on spirit. Spirit, and they've got to dig deep down into that well of intestinal fortitude. What have they got? What is keeping them going?
What's keeping Aung La going is this crowd. This is when the crowd is going to lift you and drive you, because you're competing for something bigger than yourself. You're competing for all these thousands of people that are rooting you on.
This is like Creed versus Balboa, and it's Aung La N Sang. Throwing the back there, goes to the knees!
Knee to the credit, Hasegawa! Continue to inflict damage!
I'd like him to go knees to the body. He's got the space, he can knee to the body here.
How is Hasegawa surviving? This is insane! The left hand from Aung La N Sang.
Up one hook goes in. Aung La might take the back with 30 seconds to go.
Can Hasegawa survive the round? Aung La N Sang tries to get the second hook in to no avail. It's a turtle shell here from Hasegawa. Olivia Post having a look at Hasegawa's face. Aung La punishes him even more. The electricity in here. You can feel it. Every hair in your body is tingling. One more round to go of what is one championship epicness.
Aung La looks wobbled, but Ken Hasegawa looks the worst of the two. But wow, look at this grappling exchange right here. Hasegawa continues to push forward. Aung La sprawls out very heavy, gets control there in the clinch, throws a knee to the body as the mouthpiece goes down. Here was how they finished the round. Aung La rolls into the rear naked choke. Looks like he's face cranking there. The choke's not in, it's a face crank. Hasegawa defends the hooks very well, still aware, completely aware of his surroundings, able to scramble back up on top, and then to finish with Aung La on top.
Amazing scenes. There are matches across all sports that go down in history as simply unforgettable. This is one of them. This is unforgettable. And look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts code of honor. Hasegawa is seeing out of one eye.
Hasegawa's got to keep his guard up. That right eye is almost swollen shut as Aung La marches forward as he's looking the fresher of the two.
Both men throwing punches. A gripping left hand there from Aung La N Sang and sends the mouth guard of Hasegawa flying.
That's a risky run when your mouth hangs open like that. One well-placed punch and your mouthpiece will pop out.
Hasegawa jabs, backs off the champion with the left cross. Anything can happen in the sport of transition. The inner left wing of Aung La N Sang coming out on that occasion. A curling lead hand from the challenger. Backs up the champion again. Aung La dances out of trouble. Goes to the body. Hasegawa misses with a lead uppercut. The crowd on the edge of their seats. In fact, most of them here are standing. Their national hero, Aung La N Sang, the most famous man in Myanmar. 3:20 away from possibly retaining his championship. We said Hasegawa on paper was his toughest opponent ever. Certainly that has been the case. Aung La puts all his stuff behind the right hand. A jab and a southpaw stance.
What a beautiful trip takedown as Aung La gets on top. Hasegawa's defending the hooks. And he can't let Aung La wrap his legs around his body, but he gets back up.
Hasegawa defends. He's back to his feet. Almost halfway through the round. A jab from the champion. A cross and a jab from the arm-heavy challenger. The gas tank on Hasegawa. Extraordinary, the durability. Aung La N Sang
sets. Goes to the midsection of the lead hand. Eats a nice stiff jab from Hasegawa. Aung La switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Under 2 minutes.